You're watching Truth vs. Hype. In this so-called new India that we find ourselves in, public expressions of bigotry, hate, threats to violence, actual violence have become so commonplace that we've become immune to it. But a report aired by NDTV earlier this week where those accused of lynching men in the name of the cow bragged about their violent actions appears to have touched a nerve. Rarely have I come across a story done by this network which seems to have evoked this kind of widespread response in the public sphere. What you're seeing on screen is only a handful of the kind of reactions that the report seems to have generated across the board. In the end, though, for the families of the victims and for the cause of justice, what counts is not just anger or outrage, but actual action on the ground. It appears, as we'll see shortly, that at least in theory, there is the promise of action. But first, let's just recall our report to those who perhaps may not still be conversant with it. We sent a team armed with hidden cameras to the location of two major lynching cases. In Hapur, in western Uttar Pradesh, where a man called Qasim was beaten to death, and another, Samiuddin, was badly injured. The team also travelled to Alwar in Rajasthan, where in April last year, a man called Pehlu Khan was killed by a mob. In both cases, the police had made a series of arrests, but the accused walked out on bail and are now comfortably home. Also, in both cases, another common thread that ties them, the court orders granting bail was similar, citing a lack of evidence, saying that the men were part of a crowd, there was no specific charge that had been brought against them, and so on. In both cases, though, lawyers for the victims have raised doubts over the police investigation. And hence our decision to meet the accused, pretending to be ideologically aligned to them and to speak to them on hidden camera. Remember, to the court, while appealing for bail, these men have pleaded innocence, saying they had nothing to do with the crime. But when we turned on the hidden cameras, this is a recap of what we found, starting with Rakesh, the main accused in the Hapur lynching case.
पहली बार जेल गया थोड़ा डर लगना चाहिए था नहीं और वहां भी मैंने धूम मचाई जेल के अंदर मुझे खुश हुआ और जेलर को मैंने जाते ही बताया जब उसके सामने पेश हुआ किस केस में हो आई हो 302-307 फुल मर्डर हाफ मर्डर क्यों हुआ क्या हुआ मैं गाय काट रहे थे हमने उसको काट के बात खत्म नहीं किसी जेल से जेलर से भी
हमने बोला ना काट के बोला आपने
हाँ मैंने कहा मुसलमान गाय काट रहे थे हमने उसको काट दिया जेलर के सामने अंदर जाते आसिम को मुझसे कह रहा था भैया आवाज़ नहीं निकल रही थी उससे थोड़ा पानी पानी के सहारा जाओ मैं तुझे पानी पिलाएगा तुम कहते नहीं मरती हुई गाय को पानी नहीं दिया और ये मेरी फौज आज तुझे छोड़ेगी नहीं एक एक मिनट मारेगी मुझे लग नहीं रहा था कासिम मरेगा मुझे पता था वो मरेगा समय दिन वो बच गया
हम लोग डेढ़ घंटे तक पीटते रहे पहले 10 आदमी आए फिर
20
500 लोग एकत्रित हो गए
आपने कितना मारा
मतलब डेढ़ घंटे तक कोई गिनती थोड़ी थी मतलब
कोई भी आया कोई जाए थप्पड़ मारना
कभी किसी के कभी किसी के कभी किसी के
आप लोग मार रहे थे लगातार काफी आपने गाड़ी पर काफी निकली थी
हाँ मैंने निकाली थी वो मतलब फिर भी बाइक आगे लगाने के बाद वो रोक नहीं रहे थे बाइक फिर मैंने जबरदस्ती चाबी निकाल के उनको बाहर निकाल दिया अब मतलब 3-4 थे वो भी इतने ही थे फर्स्ट टाइम में तो चाबी दोनों पिक पोंग मेरे पास ही थी उसके बाद वो चाबी लेकर मैं आ गया
Okay, now since those chilling accounts aired, three things have happened. In the Hapur case, the lawyers for Samiuddin have moved the Supreme Court asking for an early hearing of their plea that the case be transferred out of Uttar Pradesh. That's the first impact. They've also filed a copy of our report before the court. Police officials in two states have also told NDTV that they will treat the sting as what is known as an extrajudicial confession and move to cancel the bail of the two men featured in it.
Seen your program, and I could hear the legal experts on your program clearly stating that this tantamounts to an extrajudicial confession. We have taken cognizance of the extrajudicial confession, and after seeking legal advice on this, we will probably do the needful and ensure that this is sent to the court for bail cancellation and the needful action, which is admissible as per law.
First endeavor to take this evidence on record and then carry out some supporting investigation so that it becomes admissible before a court of law. Thereafter, we will cite this evidence in trial against the accused, as well as we'll try to get his bail concealed because he has obtained bail specifically on the grounds that his role was not specific, his name was not in the FIR. Now it has come in the form of extrajudicial confession, and this has made the case very strong and watertight against him.
Okay, those were senior officials in Lucknow and in Jaipur. We've also been speaking to the actual ground police officials who are in charge of these cases. And tonight we had some surprising news. Local police officials who are in charge of the Hapur case have told NDTV that they've actually gone ahead and moved court for cancelling the bail of Rakesh Sisodia on the basis of our sting. This is somewhat odd since they've not yet approached us for the sting footage. We also had spoken to police officials in the Pehlu case on the ground, and they also claim that they're studying the sting, or they've asked for the sting from NDTV. They've put in a kind of informal request, and they're going to go ahead and perhaps take some action. Let's actually, before I go to panel, let's go across to Kushal Singh. He's the circle officer of Behror, where the actual Pehlu case is being investigated. Kushal Singh ji, bahut dhanyawad, aap hamare phone pe jude, hamare program pe jude. क्या आप बता सकते हैं कि ये जो हमारी जो स्टिंग ऑपरेशन हमने की, इसके बाद आप कुछ कार्रवाई कर रहे हैं जमीनी तौर पे?
जी हाँ, जो एनडीटीवी ने स्टिंग ऑपरेशन किया है उसकी हमने फुटेज देखी थी टीवी पर, अच्छी तरह से विचार विमर्श किया है. अधिकारियों का आदेश से हमने ईमेल किया है, संपर्क किया एनडीटीवी के हेडक्वार्टर दिल्ली से, और वहां से हम शीघ्र ही ओरिजिनल फुटेज प्राप्त करके और इस संबंध में जो कि एक्स्ट्रा जुडिशियल कन्फेशन मिस्टर विपिन यादव, जिसको हमने पहले अरेस्ट किया था, जिसकी ऑनरेबल हाईकोर्ट से बेल हो गई है, उसकी बेल कैंसिलेशन कराने के लिए हम अपने जो पब्लिक प्रोसिक्यूटर से सीनियर्स, उनसे बात करके हाईकोर्ट के अंदर एक अप्लीकेशन मूव करेंगे ताकि हम इनकी इसकी जो बेल हुई है उसको खारिज करवा सके.
अच्छा, तो इस पर आप एक्शन आप लेंगे?
जी हाँ, निश्चित रूप से लेंगे.
तो एक सवाल लेकिन ये भी उठता है कि सर, आप बता सकते हैं कुशल सिंह जी कि ये तो बहुत अच्छी बात है कि आप एक्शन ले रहे हैं, वी अप्रिशिएट दिस, और आप हमें अप्रोच करेंगे फॉर्मली आपका रिक्वेस्ट का, वी आर अवेटिंग योर रिक्वेस्ट. लेकिन ये जो जेंटलमैन है, किस तरह से कोर्ट ने कहा कि आप इनके सामने एविडेंस पेश नहीं कर पाए इसीलिए इन्हें बेल हो गई, और ये इतने डिटेल में बता रहे हैं कि उनका रोल क्या था?
मैंने अभी ज्वाइन किया है, 1 अगस्त को ज्वाइन किया है, लेकिन मैं पूरे डॉक्यूमेंट, पूरी जो फाइल है उसका अध्ययन कर रहा हूं, और उसके बाद ही पूरे ऑर्डर्स पढ़ने के बाद ही मैं ऑथेंटिक रूप से कुछ कह पाऊंगा.
अच्छा, आपने अभी अभी ज्वाइन किया है तो आप इसका बैकग्राउंड से आप इतने परिचित नहीं है?
हाँ, उस समय मैं नहीं था, लेकिन मैं फाइल पढ़ रहा हूँ, देख रहा हूँ, उसके अंदर जितने भी ऑर्डर्स हुए हैं, जो भी एविडेंस इकट्ठी की, उसका भी अध्ययन कर रहे हैं ताकि हम उसमें देख सके कि माननीय उच्च न्यायालय राजस्थान जयपुर में हम किस प्रकार बेहतर तरीके से एविडेंस वगैरह पेश कर सके ताकि उसकी बेल खारिज हो.
राइट, ओके, कुशल सिंह जी, थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर ज्वाइनिंग अस on the show. So he is of course saying that they are going to approach us formally and they are going to actually move ahead and try to get the bail cancelled of Vipin Yadav, who was featured in the sting. Joining us tonight also on the show, Vrinda Grover, who is a lawyer for the victims in the Hapur case. Also Hukum Chand Sharma, he is a lawyer for the accused in the Pehlu Khan case. Asad Hayat is a lawyer and activist who is looking after the Pehlu Khan case amongst several other cases. Sandeep Singh, he's an author, right-wing activist, founder of Swastik, joining us from Mumbai. He's a supporter of the BJP. And Navsharan Singh, independent researcher, part of what was called the Karwan, a Mohabbat journey that was visiting the sites of many of these lynchings and other attacks. Vrinda Grover, I just want to start with you, just to first get a simple clarification. This information that we got, our reporters got from the ground in Hapur, that the police are saying they've actually gone ahead and moved the court for cancelling the bail of Rakesh Sisodia. Have you heard anything about this at all?
Not at all. If they need to have the bail of Rakesh Sisodia cancelled, they would be required to move to the Allahabad High Court, as the bail has been granted by the Sessions Court. I think we should put this a little bit in perspective.
Sure.
And also a clarification. I had filed the writ petition on behalf of Samedin and others in the Supreme Court of India on 4th of August prior to the sting operations telecast.
Yes.
We have thereafter requested for early hearing and file as additional documents the sting operation as it was telecast by your channel. I think what we need to understand here is that on Monday, which is day after tomorrow, the matter is listed before the Honorable Chief Justice of India. The state of Uttar Pradesh, which has been actually doing everything, and I am saying with full responsibility, from senior officers to the officer of the Pilakwa police station, they have done everything that they could to completely derail the investigation and deny justice to the victims. Mm. Now, thanks to the sting operation and the fact that the matter is about to be heard before the Supreme Court, we are seeing this flurry of action. I think what we need to pause and think,
okay,
there is a law of the land. There are police officers who are given authority and power to actually act according to law.
Hmm.
Are we going to wait now for news channels to do sting operations,
right,
and for the Supreme Court after the lynching judgment where everybody's role has been identified?
Hmm.
Nobody is listening to the Supreme Court of India. 2 days before they to appear before the Supreme Court, paperwork will be done,
yes,
so that the counsel on behalf of the state of UP can say to the court, we have moved for cancellation of bail. There is not an iota of truth in anything that they are saying to us.
But at the moment though, Vrinda, the fact that we had these two senior police officials in Rajasthan and in Uttar Pradesh saying that post the sting, they are going to act, do you feel reassured by that?
Not at all. We cannot believe the police of Uttar Pradesh will do any honest, impartial, competent investigation.
They have
deliberately destroyed the case.
Okay, let me come back to you for more specifics on that. But I just want to get a quick reaction from Sandeep Singh. That Sandeep Singh, why does it take a sting to actually get the police to act in a manner that is seen as fair until then it appears that the police was actually batting for the accused?
You know, there is no evidence that police was backing the accused. You know, we have a freedom of expression. We can go and make any allegation on the police and the state government of UP. We have seen that these people, same people, were arrested by the same police. They were granted bail by the court. It was not the police which left them. Now, police highest officials are saying that we are going to work against that bail cancellation. So instead of appreciating any of it, we try to put accusation on the police officer.
But isn't
so
the point that
we have freedom of expression?
The only thing is that the only point here, though, Sandeep Singh, is that isn't it the infirmities in the police investigation in the first place that led these men to get bail? Given that by their own admission, they had such a prominent role to play in the lynchings. So it could be incompetence. It could be collusion. I'm not necessarily saying it's one or the other, but I'm saying clearly it's one of the two.
I'm not sure whether they were allowed to be in the police custody or where police could have integrated them and could have got the factual answer. I don't think any criminal is going to go and stand up and say, yes, I have committed the crime.
Well, that's for the police then to produce the proof to do that. Of course, the criminal is not going to admit to his crime. But if I can just bring in Hukum Chand Sharma, so Hukum Chand ji, ye bataiye ki aap vakil hain, ye jo sare pehlu case ke jo accused hain, to ab aap hi ke shayad client hain Vipin Yadav, mujhe pata nahi, but is tarah se jo unki admission ho gayi hai sting operation mein, wo keh rahe hain ki maine ye kiya tha Pehlu Khan ko, maine 1.5 ghante peeta, ab police un pe karwai karne wali hai, ab aapki kya stand rahegi?
We see police what is doing after any action taken by police.
Yes.
Then we will see.
But what do you make of the fact that
matter pending in court, charge sheet is already filed, and trial is continue.
Okay, but are you still maintaining that Vipin Yadav is innocent even after on the sting he was heard saying that he was part of the mob that beat Pehlu Khan?
I don't know in what circumstances he say. I don't know, under any pressure, under voluntary. There is a many legal problems. when any time the extrajudicial confession would be on record, then we will see the what fate of the that legal extrajudicial confession. Now there is a nothing on the file. So
is your
nothing
position
on file? What
no, I will no, no, can be said? You, sir, I am asking you for your position. You continue to maintain that he is innocent.
My position, to my professional ethic, I depend to my client.
Okay, you depend to your client. Fair enough. Asad Hayat sahab, is
yes, sir.
अभी हमने देखा कि हापुर केस में तो कह रही है पुलिस की कुछ एक्शन लेगी, और हमने अभी सुना भी कि जो कुशल सिंह जी हैं सर्कल ऑफिसर बहरोड़ में, पहलू केस में भी वो कह रहे हैं कि एक्शन लेंगे. क्या इससे आप थोड़े से वो हैं, रीअश्योर्ड हैं कि एक्शन होगा?
इनके अब तक का जो चाल चलन रहा है इन्वेस्टिगेशन का, उससे तो हम सेटिस्फाई हो ही नहीं सकते. नंबर वन, मैं थोड़ा सा और क्लियर कर दूं कि पहलू ने अपना डाइंग डिक्लेरेशन दिया था
जी,
और FIR में वो लिखा है सब कुछ
जी.
उस पुलिस अफसर का इन्होंने इन्वेस्टिगेशन में स्टेटमेंट ही रिकॉर्ड नहीं किया. एक कॉर्पोरेशन था वो, उन छह लोगों के खिलाफ होता जो जिनके नाम उसमें मेंशन किए गए थे.
फेयर इनफ. बट इन दिस पर्टिकुलर
मैं अर्ज करूं, उसके अलावा हमने अभी इस स्टिंग ऑपरेशन के बाद जो एक इंजर्ड विटनेस है अजमत, उसकी तरफ से रिप्रेजेंटेशन भेज दिया है रजिस्टर्ड स्टेट को और इन्वेस्टिगेशन एजेंसी को
राइट,
और इनको भी SHO साहब को. उसमें हमने कहा है कि आप स्टिंग ऑपरेशन में जो भी कुछ मटेरियल आया है उसको इन्वेस्टिगेशन में, फर्दर इन्वेस्टिगेशन में आप शामिल कीजिए. और सबसे बड़ी बात हमने ये कही है, देखिए बेल की बात आप कह रहे हैं कि बेल कैंसिलेशन होना चाहिए, लेकिन हम कह रहे हैं इस बात को कि सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने अपने ऑर्डर में कहा है कि स्पेशल कोर्ट बनाइए
For lynching cases.
और फास्ट ट्रैक कोर्ट बनाइए. आप छह महीने के अंदर उस केस को डिसाइड कीजिए और डेली बेसिस पर हेयरिंग कीजिए.
तो हमने ये भी दैट इज ऑफ कोर्स द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट थिंग, बट आई जस्ट वांट टू क्लेरिफाई वन क्विक थिंग फ्रॉम यू दैट यू कंटिन्यू टू मेंटेन दैट विपिन यादव वाज अ मेन अक्यूज्ड.
यस,
एंड ही इज देयर वेरी मच अकॉर्डिंग टू योर साइड ऑन द स्पॉट एंड डूइंग द बीटिंग, एंड नाउ ही इज देयर एडमिटिंग इट ऑन कैमरा.
उनका एक्स्ट्रा जुडिशियल कन्फेशन है, अगर ये फर्दर इन्वेस्टिगेशन में उसको नहीं लेंगे, शामिल नहीं करेंगे, तो हम उसको कोर्ट में रखेंगे.
यू नो नवशरण, द थिंग अबाउट ऑल ऑफ दिस इज दैट वन इज ऑफ कोर्स द एंटायर बिजनेस ऑफ द लीगल साइड ऑफ इट, बट द फैक्ट इज, एंड दिस इज समथिंग दैट आई हैव स्टिल नॉट बीन एबल टू गेट ओवर, व्हेन यू हियर दीज मेन यूजिंग दैट काइंड ऑफ लैंग्वेज डिस्क्राइबिंग व्हाट दे डिड, दिस ऑलमोस्ट सीम्स टू गो बियॉन्ड समथिंग व्हिच कैन इवन बी टैकल्ड with the frame of law. And I suspect that that's what you must have discovered, you and Harsh and others, repeatedly on your journey.
Absolutely. When we were there, we heard all of this. And right. In fact, this particular sting, which is chilling, by the way, is only corroborating what we have been hearing in our various journeys. In the case of Hapur killings, we were there and we talked to Qasim's family, we talked to Samadeen's family. They told us everything that the person is saying on camera. In fact, we went there 5 days after the killings had happened and were taken to the fields where the two men were killed, and we saw the blood-soaked mud there, the chapels of
Samadhi. One killed and one injured.
One killed and one injured. And we
and
met
that was
with
still there? The
it
evidence
was still
that,
there.
Because that is
it
evidence.
Was, absolutely. It was there. We could take pictures. We could stand there. We could do, and there was no cordoning off the area. Nobody had taken any samples, nothing. Mm. All the villagers gathered there and they told us how, from which mic, they made this announcement that these two men are slaughtering cows. There was no cow around. There was no blood of an animal. And they were beaten, like when we spoke to Qasim's family, his family told us that there was not an inch of his body which was not wounded. He was attacked
horrific.
So brutally, even his ears were filled with wet mud, and the brutal attack on him. And even
Samuddin, we saw, you know, what had happened to him. So it's really, I mean, I don't know how one deals with this kind of hatred more than anything else. But I just want to ask you something, Sandeep Singh, that would you describe these men, the men that we've heard now all week, accepting their role in attacking and killing others on the basis of religion, would you describe them as terrorists, Sandeep Singh?
No, I won't. Because terrorist has a very clear-cut definition where they won't let you practice your religion and they will kill you for that. This was not that case. So it can be called terrorist.
This is precisely that. I mean, they said...
No, it is not.
They've clearly said in their own admission that these men were killed because of the fact that they were Muslim. Yep. In fact, one of them says that I want to kill 1,000 members of the minority community.
They were killing bee. They were killing cow. They were killing cows.
There was no...
This is a case of hurting religious sentiment.
No, hold on.
It was not a case of stopping the religious
sentiment. There's no proof of that.
I think Mr. Sandeep Singh should be stopped.
Sandeep Singh, let me stop you right there. There's absolutely no proof that they were killing cows. Proof.
He cannot say on the... Yes, please stop him.
You cannot make these kind of statements on a case that is pending.
I just said what the man said based on that. You are just making an accusation because he said that it's a terrorist. My answer is, if you're saying
that justifies, even if for a minute you assume that there was that allegation of which there is no proof, that's exactly the justification that terrorists use. They always have a grievance, right? They're killing because they feel that some wrong has been done by the victim. In some ways, there's an association of wrong with the victim. The definition of terrorist is somebody who kills for a religious or a political cause. It's not an ordinary crime. How is this not terrorism?
Self-exhumed law protector bane hai ye log. To Supreme Court ne bhi yehi kaha hai.
It's the first case of instigating the people by killing the cow. It's a different way. It's not this.
My God, again you are repeating something which is not correct. And even if it is correct, that doesn't justify.
Aap usko trade kyun nahi mante?
Okay.
Last hounded off.
Slaughtering ka bhi proof hona chahiye na.
That is what is happening here. Okay, last. You cannot call them terrorists.
Okay, well that's the problem. That is the problem. Vrinda Grover, we literally have 30 seconds.
मैं नहीं कर रहा हूँ. मैं कह रहा हूँ कि heinous crime है और proof है कि नहीं. बात यहाँ हुई कि उन्होंने क्या confess किया, किस basis पे मारा.
Okay, Nafshan, I'll let you have the last word. I mean. To me, this is increasingly becoming almost like a form of terrorism. There is an ideology here, there is a hatred towards another community, and then you're carrying out an action, you're carrying out violence.
This is nothing to do with the cow, there is no cow involved, it is only hate crime, and this moral vandalism is actually going on by making the entire community criminalized.
Yes.
I think there is a collusion of police and the state, and when we see that there is the judiciary which is granting bails to criminals, when we have the executive, when we have the police, which is actually acting in collusion, when we have the legislature where the Prime Minister has refused to speak, there are ministers who are there to back up the criminals, and so there are wider, those. There's a wider crisis
a wider
here.
Concern.
There is no rule of law. If this is going to continue, then that means the rule of law is only on the books and not in practice.
I know that we want to have... more people want to come in, but we're completely short of time. But of course, we will continue to track this story very closely as we have. Thank you all so much for joining us. That's all the time we have on Truth vs. Hype. Thanks for watching. Good night.